We're in the Permian period. Look at that creature on the left, everybody. Wow. It looks like a nautical animal with that sail on its back. It's called the Demetrodon. It uses that sail to regulate its body temperature by angling it toward or away from the sun. And despite the fact that it looks like a lizard, it's actually an early relative of mammals, not a dinosaur or a lizard. Oh, wait, hold on. I think we're sailing away to another time here. Everybody hold on tight. Here we go! Woo! Wow, I wonder where we are this time. Oh, look over there! A Plateosaurus, guys! We must be in the Triassic period! This is when dinosaurs first appeared on the planet 210 million years in the past. The Plateosaurus is a plant eater, a vegetarian, so to speak. And it's believed that it traveled in herds like modern-day antelopes. Oh, look over there! A pair of Paracelophysis, everybody! Wow, on the cliff, do you guys see it? Wow, what a rare sight, everybody! The Paracelophysis was one of the first known genera of dinosaurs. They were small carnivores about 10 feet long, and they hunted in packs like modern-day hyenas. Oh, wow. Amazing. Uh-oh, that one is looking straight at our vehicle, so I think we better get out of here, Driver Taylor. We're getting out of here, please. Oh, wait. We're timed up again! Oh, boy! Oh, heads up, bump! We won, too! Oh, wow. What the left is first, guys? And a baby one on the right? Let's set the facts straight about these crescent lizards. They were not so small, about 20 feet, and they weighed to 1,000 pounds. Very impressive, right? Look over here. There's a bigger one over here. Very impressive, guys. And look at the headpiece. Distinctive for the Dilophosaurus! Gross. Look at the Cryolophosaurus over there, guys. You see the crest on top of its head? That has been likened to a pompadour, and scientists have informed me that the Elvisaurus after singer Elvis Presley. I know. And look at the red one in the front, guys. That's the Allosaurus. They were the most common predators in North America during the late Jurassic period. They had strong jaws equipped with large, sharp, serrated teeth, and they used their upper jaws to hatchet and ambush their prey. And behind, we have the gentle veggie-eating Brachiosaurus. A mature one can grow to be 35 tons, with the neck that stretches 30 feet long, and it was definitely a very impressive dinosaur. A long neck allowed the Brachiosaurus to forage on stems and leaves too high for other animals to reach. Wow, guys. Whoa, guys, we're approaching the time portal cave here. Oh man, this is amazing. I don't know what's in the cave though, so please keep everything inside the vehicle. I don't want to lose any of you guys here. Oh boy, here we go! Oh! Watch out for that pair of Stegosaurus, everybody! They're herbivores, but they have a mouth and they will bite! Oh, wow. Look like little aliens, don't they?
Sound like sheep.
We must be in the Cretaceous period now, guys. Look at the beautifully feathered cityopathy on the right, everybody. Doesn't that remind you of an emu or an ostrich? Scientists believe both father and mother cityopathy cared for the nest and eggs just like the modern ostrich.
May I have a sit-down? Thank you.
Oh, wait. I see what's going on here. It's being chased by a pack of Deinonychus, everybody. Oh, no. You better run, cityopathy. I really hope you don't get eaten. Guys, look over there. The mighty Carnotaurus lurking behind the tree over here. Wow. Scientists call them a meat-eating bull, and those two for sure convince me. Oh wow, and look at the massive horns on that Tornosaurus over there on the left. Looks like a fearsome meat-eater, but it's actually just an herbivore. Rows of sharp teeth allowed it to chew on the toughest of vegetation. Oh, and there's a Triceratops over here! Oh, a little baby one on the hill too! How cute! Aww. The Triceratops has massive heads that took about a third of the body. Very huge. Wow.
Cool.
Whoa, talk about big heads. Look at that Pachycephalosaurus over there.
Oh my God.
That's a weird looking dinosaur, isn't it? Yeah. That name, Pachycephalosaurus, means thick-headed lizards, and I think we can all understand why. The 10-inch bone on top of its head were used by the males to possibly headbutt each other for dominance or territory disputes. Wow. Oh my goodness, guys, I didn't think we were going to find one, but we did! The holy grail of all dinosaurs, the king of lizards, the Tyrannosaurus Rex, everybody! Wow! At 7 tons and 40 feet long, considered the largest carnivore of all time. More recently, scientists have discovered a Gigantosaurus, a Spinosaurus, at 20 tons and 60 feet long. Amazing, right? If you guys want to quickly stand up, you can grab a picture of those baby T-Rexes over here. Do you guys see them? They're between the two dinosaurs in those bushes. Very cute, right?
I don't think Mama's too happy about having that older dinosaur near her babies.
Hey, little baby, a T-Rex, how cute! Should we be worried about those babies though? The Quetzalcoatlus is hovering really close. Cool fact about this winged reptile, it's a pterosaur with a wingspan exceeding 30 feet, and it was one of the largest creatures to ever fly on Earth. Very impressive indeed. Alright everybody, please take your seat again, thank you. But you know what? I think Mother T-Rex can defend her nest pretty well though. She had a powerful sense of smell and strong claws in the apex predator of her day, much like the modern day lion. She also scared off other predators and ate their meals too. Opportunistic dinosaurs. Taylor!
Hey, Taylor! Where are you going? What's going on?
Oh, guys, look over there! A baby onyx coming out of the water! A long snout, sharp teeth, perfect for gripping slippery fish. What's going on though? Why isn't she stopping? That's not the...
Dinosaurs are far at a base camp. Can you come in?
Oh no guys, my radio's not working either. Oh, this is not good though. And there's a building on our right. That's not in the Cretaceous period. What's going on? Oh wait, I know what's going on. Time must be breaking down on us, everybody. Oh no, we gotta get back to base camp. Look, Brachiosaurus over there. We're really jumping around in time now. Oh man, I don't want to be trapped in the past. I don't want to be dinosaur food, please. You gotta get us back. Dr. Taylor, I have so much to live for. No!
Wait, I see some people up front.